Being a person of color, I knew that at some point in my career, I would probably experience some kind of discrimination or just something where we're not seeing eye to eye culturally. I thought I was prepared for a situation like that. And the virtual reality simulation kind of showed me that I wasn't as prepared as I thought I was.
Here at the Columbia University Irving Medical Center and in the occupational therapy programs, we value our mission for diversity, equity, and inclusion, and specifically inclusive teaching. For that, we received the grant from the Provost Office for Teaching and Learning, where we use virtual reality with the help of the emerging technology team, using the software called Equal Reality to complement a course in our program, which is new course in the curriculum that we're really excited about, called Diversity, Equity, Inclusion, and Professional Skills.
We learned a lot about intersectionality and being able to view a person as a whole. And I think especially for the field of occupational therapy, where we're very client-centered, it was really nice to be able to kind of break down those biases and kind of promote cultural sensitivity and humility, and that was done through all the VR.
This project will help the students practice these skills that they need to address bias, discrimination, microaggression, while they are occupational therapy practitioner, and one day when they are interacting with clients and their families and other healthcare professionals.
I think the virtual reality gives you the best experience and the most realistic sense of what you will experience in the real world. I don't really think it could be recreated through any other form of teaching.
One of the great things about virtual reality is students get to learn about bias and microaggressions on their own pace without feeling the pressure of interacting with another classmates in the moment or the needing to articulate their thoughts on the spot.
In the VR experience, it starts off with a mirror in front of you. And in this mirror, you can move around and you are a different person. Whether it is a person of color, a person of an older age or a younger age, it starts to psychologically trick you into thinking that this is who you are and this is who you are in this experience. So it gives you a lot better of a perspective when you start to go into those situations and the simulation to really start to feel and empathize with that person that they are portraying for you to be.
You were able to press as many times as you felt that bias was happening, and as I kept pressing, I kept feeling that bias was occurring, and you see afterwards how many buttons you press versus how much bias actually occurred, and I wasn't even close, and it's just a good chance to reflect on your own bias and see where you could change.
After they're done with that technology, we open it then to class discussions and group discussions, which will allow to a deeper conversations.
I'm grateful for this experience because it gave me light into something that I've never had before, and I know it sets me apart from other future clinicians because I'll have this perspective that maybe others didn't, and it'll let me be able to communicate with my clients in a more open and respectable way.
Columbia University has a mission towards teaching excellence, and following that, we are leading the way for the profession to use virtual reality and technology. We are the first program that does that in the profession, and there's only more to come and the use of more technology in our courses.